So let us now move on to the advanced engine combustion strategies available. Now, the advanced engine combustion technologies basically deals with the in-cylinder, what is actually happening inside the combustion chamber. Now, in both the cases, whether it is SI engine or a diesel engine, combustion is basically happening inside the combustion chamber. And I always give an analogy to this. The concept of engine, which has come to the human beings, I always say it has come from the human beings itself. So whatever is food to the human being, it is fuel to the engine. And whatever is there, the food we eat, accordingly we give performance. Now similarly, whatever fuel you supply to the engine and whatever happens inside the combustion chamber, accordingly an output performance or emission is being reflected by that. So a lot of study is being done ki what is happening inside the combustion chamber. In order to study the in-cylinder combustion, very, very sophisticated devices are required. So maybe we in our country, we may have only 2-3 labs which are equipped with that. And mostly whatever we do is outside that. And most of the research which is being carried out here and during our interaction, some of you were talking about the PhD or research work. It is only we are measuring the performance. We are measuring the emission parameters. We are measuring the performance, that is brake thermal efficiency, heat release, something like that. By either mixing the fuel, that's all. And nothing is being carried out into the engine section. And a very high level of, I would say, knowledge, equipment, laboratory is required to understand the anatomy of an engine. So basically, here what we do, mostly the engines are being designed outside. We are procuring them, using them, and getting the work done. As is the case with most of the mobiles, most of the computers. So we are only importing this and we are making use as an applicant. So the first thing I think I have already talked about is the low temperature combustion strategy. Now, if we see NOx, NOx is a parameter which is associated with temperature. Now, the NOx, amount of NOx emitted as a pollutant from the engine keeps on increasing in an exponential way as the temperature increases. Now, say for example, at 1000 degree centigrade combustion chamber temperature, X amount of NOx is released. And at 1500, it may be X plus X plus X plus X. It will not be 1.5 times, but it will be many, many times more. So that is the behavior of NOx. And as we all know, air has got two components. Now 21% and 79%. 79% is your nitrogen. Now, nitrogen at normal temperature do not participate into the combustion chamber reaction because we are also inhaling nitrogen, but it is not participating because the temperature inside our stomach is maybe 31, 32, 34, 35, 36 degrees. But engine also inhales air, same oxygen and same NOx, but it produces NOx. because it is working at a temperature of around 2000 degrees centigrade. So that is the biggest. So for that matter, the maximum amount of NOx is being produced by gas turbines or gas engines, which are being used in aircraft. More than 90-95% NOx is being produced there. So that is why we have to be very, very cautious in dealing with this. So if we are able to decrease the combustion chamber temperature somewhat lower than what it used to be, so definitely we will be able to control NOx emission. So low temperature emission to low temperature combustion, so NOx can be
minimized.
Yes. So the LTC, that is low temperature combustion, offers a number of advantages over conventional combustion. The fuel air mixture and combustion properties permit the engine to be more efficient than conventional engine. The energy losses in the engine is less over the cylinder walls to the atmosphere due to lower. So one, you reduce the NOx. Another, you reduce the energy loss which is there through the walls of the combustion chamber. So both way, it is beneficial. So with a low temperature combustion, we may be achieve ultra low engine exhaust emissions, which could significantly decrease the cost and after treatment devices or penalties for fuel economy. Now, if we have a high temperature combustion, the exhaust emission after treatment devices will have to be more stronger. So when we have low temperature combustion devices, a low temperature control after treatment device can be used for the emission control. Now, clean diesel combustion strategy. Now, in this, more air or lean, this is similar to lean combustion technology. That means more amount of air is being inducted into the combustion chamber as required as per the stoichiometric air fuel mixture conditions. So we induct purposely more air for leaner combustion. So that leaner combustion can be treated as cleaner combustion. Lean combustion is a clean combustion. So another analogy I used to give into my classroom is ki what we do with the yoga, what we do with sports, with our body. The only thing which we do with yoga or sports is that we inhale more amount of air. We fill in our lungs. Nothing else. You do any physical activity, your inhaling rate increases. And that means it is better for the food which is there in your stomach. So fuel or food is nothing but carbohydrates. So in order to, for combustion, you need sufficient amount of air. So human beings always remain deficient of air. You start inhaling more air, you give more air to the engine, it will produce lean combustion and you will get lesser number of pollutants and better performance. So the same analogy works here. And this has been possible with the use of computer control, high pressure fuel injection, multi-pulse fuel injection system, so EGR. So all these things make use of clean diesel fuel technology. Now, exhaust after treatment strategies or devices. Now, exhaust emission of NOx and PM, they have been reduced to more than 80 or 90% from the previous years. And this has been done with the modification, retarded timing, cool EGR system, and high injection pressure. Now, if you see the engines, diesel engines, which were being manufactured earlier to, I would say, Bharat Stage 4 or Bharat Stage 6, they were basically working on 1000 PSI injection pressure. But today, they are being used to run at 2000 PSI. Now, with such a high pressure, what is happening? In a diesel engine, we have to atomize the fuel. That means we have to break down the fuel component into finer particles. And that is only achievable with higher pressure. With lower pressure, the molecule size is bigger. Whereas with higher pressure, the molecule size is smaller. This is one thing. Another, I think, change which has come in diesel engine is the CRDI technology. I'll give you a small analogy. How many of you stay in multi-story buildings? Anybody who is staying in multi-story building? No.
Land. Hmm? Multi-story building.
No. Now, in multi-story buildings, there is one problem. Then we use, maybe some of you might be staying in hostel also. One, two. The person who is residing at the top will get a lower pressure water from the person who is at the ground level. Have you heard this phenomenon or not? The water supply system in a multi-story building, the person who are residing at the top, they keep on getting lesser water flow, lesser pressure than the person who are living at a lower level. Is it true?
Yes.
Now, this is what was happening in an engine earlier to CRDI engine. Now, the engine, the cylinder, which was nearest to the fuel injection pump was receiving the maximum amount of fuel. The cylinder which were farther away from the fuel injection system was receiving fuel lesser than the first cylinder, if it is a four cylinder engine. Yes. So because of this mismatch, because cylinder size is same in all, and all the cylinders should receive the same amount of fuel, so because of differential amount of fuel, the combustion in a multi-cylinder diesel engine was not proper. And because of that reason, we were getting noise and vibration from the engine. So this is a multi-cylinder engine having four cylinders. Now the cylinder one is nearest to this. This will receive more fuel than cylinder number two. This will receive still more fuel than three. And this will receive more. So this will get least as compared to the first, the fuel. So this is the similar to the situation which I have explained, like in multi-story buildings. So this is the ground floor, which will receive maximum pressure. And in some of the cases, when the ground floor people would always open the country, pani upar jayega bhi nahi. Okay, so this was happening in the engines before CRDI. And now how this problem has been resolved, and I think from today, you would understand the CRDI technology and never able to forget it. Now in this configuration, each of these cylinders would receive the same amount of fuel required by them. It is not the ECU. ECU is there in first case also. But ECU here is also there. ECU is there in both the cases. But ECU supplies whatever injection to give. So now, if you design a system like this, and this is known as your common rail. This. And this is a high pressure rail. And earlier, the conventional engines were running on low pressure fuel injection pumps. And now these are high fuel injection pumps. And because of this, today we are able to see the diesel engines or SA engines having almost similar audible noise, no vibration, no noise. So otherwise, initially, diesel engine start hua, so people would start with how engine chal pada. Is it understood now, CRDL? Actually, you see the distance, the time required to travel the fuel. It is because of the distance. So, this distance. So, I have exaggerated this problem.
There will be a loss.
Loss also. Yeah. Pressure loss. So, here, this rail is pressure.
Maintain the pressure.
Same pressure. You tap it from here. The pressure will be this way. Still, I think there is...
No.
Okay. So, pump does not do anything. So, the only thing is, because four tappings have to be there, so this is... pressure is slightly more than the conventional system. So, CIDMA, two changes. One, this rail. Another is the pumping system. So, it has become high pressure. And because of this reason, the entire thing has... resolved, the performance has improved, the emissions have decreased. Apart from the exhaust after treatment devices which we are talking about. So, aaj ke baad, I understand ki ab aapko CID kabhi nahi bhulega. Before I discuss these individual after treatment devices, let me show you the complete exhaust system, that how it has improved and what is there in the Bharat Stage 6 vehicles, 6 diesel vehicles, which will be fitted with this. Now, if you refer to figure 6.6, this is the transition which has taken place, or I think which is going to take place in the vehicles which are being manufactured from April 2020, whether they are passenger vehicles or they are commercial vehicles in diesel. So, you have an engine which is fitted either with EGR or without EGR. Then you will have a DOC, that is diesel oxidation catalyst, then diesel particulate filter, and then SCR, and then tailpipe. So, these three components will be there into the exhaust system of a diesel vehicle. And because of this, they were to redesign the vehicle because it has to accommodate into the limited space available with the vehicle. And secondly, all these devices are fitted with sensor, and otherwise they would not function as it is. So now going back one by one to the system, that what they do and how they work. And all of this, then recalibration of the entire software was involved. Now, oxidation catalysts in automotive were equipped maybe from 1970 onwards. We have already seen two-way, three-way catalytic reactors. So, this is an image which gives you the idea regarding the engine, the EGR, that is exhaust gas recirculation, then the control unit, then the intake, and this is the cylinder head. And in the initial system, when turbocharger were fitted, now slightly I'm taking back again to the history of, I would say, evolution of diesel engine in passenger cars in India. The first vehicle, I think, which came into passenger car segment, fitted onto the diesel engine, was from Tata's, Tata Indica. I think everybody knows this. Maybe that may be it. Yeah. Now, they launched the vehicle that was without a turbocharger. Later on, after an year or so, they came up with the upgraded version. This is Tata Indica Turbo. Then they came up with another version after 2-3 years, Turbo Intercooler. Now, as far as the diesel engine is concerned, a diesel engine is a one which is fitted with a turbocharger, which is, and in order for the functioning, better functioning of turbocharger, you need to have an intercooler. Now, first of all, why a turbocharger? Now, turbocharger is fitted onto the diesel engine because some of the diesel fuel which is there in the combustion chamber, they go out of the exhaust without participating in the combustion reaction. So that means HC emission, jisko hum log bolte hain hydrocarbon emission. You get hydrocarbon emission into the diesel engine, and which is clearly understood by the fact, if you happen to be near a diesel driven engine vehicle, you will find some smell. And from where the smell is there? Because the exhaust is also giving some amount of diesel. So that smell is being inhaled. Now, the fuel which is unburnt hydrocarbon, it has to be reinducted into the combustion chamber. So that means the resultant unburnt hydrocarbon in the exhaust are lesser. They are reused. That is why, and the system which circulates this entire process is known as EGR, exhaust gas recirculation, of which turbocharger is a part. Turbocharger is nothing but a small turbine. So we all know what is a turbine. So turbine is a power plant which works at a very high RPM. The turbine which is fitted onto the diesel engine is rotating at more than 1 lakh RPM. And to manufacture or to fit a turbocharger into the diesel engine, again, cost will go up. So the company which were manufacturing, they deleted this component, put up the automobile wheel into the market as a cheap product. Whereas I consider this as an essential part of the diesel engine. You would not find EGR or turbocharger into agriculture sector, diesel engines. They are without these. But if you happen to work on those, please try to fit in a turbocharger. You will get better results, especially for you. Now, when you supply EGR, the hydrocarbons, they are at a high temperature. You need to condense them. And in order to condense, what we do? We cool. When we cool, the exhaust would condense. So with this, more amount of fuel, exhaust can be fed. So cooling of the exhaust is also compulsory when you fit in turbocharger. So that is known as intercooler. So again, that means ki intercooler is also essential. So in the first step, they ordered turbocharger. In the next step, they fitted turbocharger, then intercooler. Then it became a complete diesel engine. So nobody knew these things, and these companies started by. So that is why, again, a model, you would find turbo written behind that. You would find intercooler written behind that. Yes, it is fitted with intercooler. But to me, at the first stage, they should have launched diesel engine vehicles with all these things. And second, today what we are talking about, Bharat Stage 6, people have already implemented in the developed countries. We are only imitating. It is not a new thing. It is new thing for India, but it is not a new thing for the world. The world already knows about the entire this thing. So, hope this thing is clear to you. So that means ki diesel engine with turbocharger, intercooler. So that makes a diesel engine, especially into automotive sector or transport sector. So now this is a catalytic converter. We supply HC means unburnt hydrocarbon, CO which is a product unburnt. This is carbon monoxide, oxides of nitrogen. When it passes through a catalytic converter, we get nitrogen, water and carbon dioxide. Now you can do one experiment in the winters. When you start your engine, you would find some droplets coming out of the tailpipe. And this corrosion which he is talking is because of that water. So for that matter, you can, I think, go for some coating and it will not be there. So coating can prevent this water. But in cooler months, like the month of November, December, when you initially start your vehicle, you would find initially some droplets of water coming out from the tailpipe. But as the temperature increases, as soon as it's come in contact with the normative cell, it disappears. Now, the room in which we are sitting here also contains some amount of water into the air, but they are so minute that they are not visible to us. They are scattered. So air is always, it has got oxygen, it has got nitrogen, it has got water, and it has got the pollutants also, always there. But we are not able to see them. So now you can witness this thing doing by an exercise. You start your diesel engine vehicle in the morning, cool months, and you would find it is there. So the carbon monoxide, the unburnt hydrocarbon, carbon monoxide, when it passes through the catalyst, it reacts with them and you get oxygen, you get water, you get carbon dioxide into the exhaust. So that is the role of DOC. Now, the next component which I talked was DPF, diesel particulate filter. Again, I'll give you one analogy. What is DPF? DPF is nothing but a mask worn by the people who are living in the high polluted cities. And you must have seen the police cop wearing a mask for inhaling. So a similar filter is fitted onto the tailpipe of the exhaust of diesel engine so that it can arrest the heavier particles into that filter and leave the smaller particles. So there, at the, like when we have a filter, it arrests which are not good for us. So similarly, it attracts, and periodically you have to clean the filter. So similar is the case here. So this exhaust, which is there, it has to be cleaned periodically. Maybe the design may be such that it will be take 50,000 kilometers or 1 lakh kilometers to replace it. So since cleaning is a difficult task, you have to entirely maybe change this component altogether. Like we have air filter. So everybody knows. So air filter needs to be cleaned, or rather it has to be cleaned or it has to be replaced after maybe 5,000 or 10,000 kilometers. Similarly, we have fuel filters. And similarly, now we have exhaust filter, which has also to be periodically cleaned. So otherwise, it will choke the exhaust and the whatever we are talking about, pollutants, that problem will remain there. So the construction of DPF is similar to a honeycomb type of structure in which the exhaust grows from one side and it comes from the other side. It has got pressure sensor, it has got temperature sensor. Okay. So now two sensors are here which are linked to the ECU. So earlier some input was there, now two more inputs are given to this. So that key operating system needs to be recalibrated. Software needs to be upgraded. So say for example, pehle 5 or 10 inputs are there, now 2 inputs are more. So detail, I'll give you this PDF and you can read this PDF for details. Now coming to your this thing, SCR, selective catalytic reduction. Now this is also a very simple thing and which has been used. Now if we see, the SCR is a procedure that uses a catalyst to change over NOx in depleted gases to nitrogen and water, which are then discharged into the air. So in order to reduce the quantity of NOx, or in order to reduce or turn NOx into nitrogen from maybe 80-90% to almost negligible 1 ppm to it, you need to react with some kind of catalyst, and then it will convert NOx into water and nitrogen. Now what this catalyst is, it is nothing but the urea which is being used in the agriculture sector. And you can see the companies, how do they do? They sell the same in the name of AdBlue. They call it as AdBlue. Now today if you find urea, you will get maybe 200, 300 for a bag of 50 kilograms. And once it's come to automobile, it will be sold 1 liter of urea costing the 50 rupees or 100 rupees. But it is nothing but a mixture of water and urea. You can make the same urea, 30, 40 grams, mix it with water, make a liquid and inject it to the NOx. And we have experimented with my PhD student. We have constructed an ordinary exhaust and we sprayed urea into this and we have seen 90% reduction of NOx. Simple mechanism. Simple spray of urea into the exhaust, measuring the exhaust before inducting the urea and after inducting the urea. So 90% reduction is there. But these companies would have a sensor. Okay. The one thing is there, yes, in order to have maximum benefit or the efficiency of this SCR device, it has to be operated at some raised temperature. So that means the whatever sensor is fitted there, initially during the cold conditions, when the engine start, the urea dosing does not start. It is only after sensing the temperature, when it reaches around 400, 500 degrees centigrade, the dosing of urea is done. That means the injector, urea injected nozzle starts dosing the, and then it is also fitted to the exhaust also. One sensor is another there, which gives you the okay, it is now going, nitrogen is going outside, NOx is not going. So feedback mechanism is there. So dosing of urea, quantity of urea, temperature sensor, this again input has to be sent to the ECU. So that means you require the upgradation. Then you require this fitment of these sensor and actuators into the system. So all these things combined together took 3-4 years time to build this. And the resultant is that now we would be able to inhale some of. So that is why I'm not going on for detail. I have given you the crux. So here I have also written. So diverse forerunners of ammonia can be utilized. However, for vehicles, the most well-known alternative solution of urea and water, for example, AdBlue. So one company, it is selling urea and mixture of water in the name of AdBlue. So you can mix, I think, 32% mixture and it will work good for this. Initially, they were used in heavy vehicles, trucks and buses. But nowadays, the high-end vehicles, they are making use of this device. So you can always reduce the size. Small pump is needed, small this thing is needed. But the only thing is, now you see the configuration of a bigger vehicle. Now the vehicle, say for example, let us talk about the engine of this thing, diesel train. So this engine is producing 5,000 HP or 6,500 horsepower. So it's a very, very big engine, which I think is equivalent to hundreds of smaller engines. So the bigger the size of the engine, larger would be the amount of exhaust. And a vehicle which is having 1000cc, 1500cc engine would be producing a very small amount of exhaust emission, which may not be, I think, even if we add this thing, the resultant benefit derived would not be there. Whereas if we target bigger vehicles like trucks or buses in transport segment, so it will cater, one vehicle would be equivalent to the 100 small passenger cars. So that is why initially they are implemented there. So this emission, I think during the our tea break, I was discussing, more the number of vehicles, more is the exhaust emission. Now again, in US, they are having 2 vehicles per person. So if the population of US is maybe 30 crores or 20 crores, so they are having 40 crore vehicles. Whereas even in our country, out of 100 people, only one is having a vehicle. So even if we are 134, the total amount of vehicles are not more than 10 crores or 15 crores. So we are not making much pollution. It is the advanced developed countries which are making more pollution than the developing countries. But the emphasis on the other way, we are not able to debate, having a debate with them. Ki, okay, just let us know how we are making more pollution than you. So you are having more number of vehicles. We are having lesser number of vehicles. So how can we produce more? So it's a different story altogether when we talk about this. So the best thing is, in case of this, is to having lesser number of vehicles. And that too, if we can turn to the this yeah. SI engines.
How many other technology reduce emission?
Technology means, I think I have already seen the plan. So alternate fuels are there. Renewable fuels are there.
CNG.
Yes, alternate or renewable. I always talk about renewable because the fossil fuels are limited. So a fuel should be such which can be grown again and again, cultivated as per our choice. So something like our agriculture. So we cultivate wheat, rice, we fill in our belly. So water, again, it's a limited. In some cities, it is going off. Many of the world countries, they're going out of water also. Ethiopia, Dochar, or Cambodia. Okay. So this is something that we can grow and then we can use. But again, there is a socio-economic effect on this. The land available to feed the human beings or the living beings will become lesser if we start growing the fuel needed to put it into vehicles. So that is also a big question. Ki people do not have maybe food to eat, but somebody is having cultivating renewable fuel to fill in his engine. So that is also a big question, whether it can be done like that. Okay. Now, as you, I'm not touching into detail, but only thing, there is hierarchy of fuel. One, you have solid fuel like coal, another liquid fuels, petrol and diesel, another gaseous fuel. So now the gaseous fuel is the most cleaner fuel than liquid fuel, than solid fuel. So if we can move from liquid fuel to gaseous of any kind, whether it is LPG, CNG, HCNG, or a combination of all these, that is a much more cleaner fuel. And secondly, we are saving energy also. Because all the fuel, liquid fuels, are vaporized, first are atomized. And in atomization, you require energy. Your fuel injection pump, it consumes energy. And if the fuel is available in the gaseous form, there is no need to atomize. You have to simply, and I have done one more experiment on this, that you can run any of the engine, simply by putting the LPG gas, which we usually have in fuel, just put that fuel into the air induction chamber, start the engine, put that into the air induction chamber, switch off the fuel supply, your engine will keep running. This is the first experiment which I did in 1997. Engine will not stop.
Without any calibration in the engine.
Without any calibration. But only thing is you will not get that performance, but it will not stop. Again, an analogy to this. Now, human beings, the God has provided two ways to eat. One is your mouth, another is your... What is the other way which you can eat? There are two ways by which you can supply food to yourself. One is your mouth. What is the other? Anybody? Simple question. It is through your nose. भाई जब किसी का एक्सीडेंट हो जाता है इस माउथ ही बाउंड तो हाउ डू दे सप्लाई नोज के थ्रू दे देते सो सिमिलरली इन एन इंजन देयर आर टू सिस्टम बाय व्हिच यू कैन सप्लाई फ्यूल वन इज योर फ्यूल इंजेक्शन सिस्टम अनदर योर एयर इंडक्शन चैम्बर द फ्यूल कैन बी सप्लाइड वो भी तो वहीं जा रहा है जहां से एयर ले रहा है वहीं से गैसियस फ्यूल डाल दो खत्म we have done M.Tech and PhD on this also. So this is similar. That is why I told you in the beginning, the entire analogy of human beings is being replicated into the engine. No component is different. You talk that component, I'll give you analogy in human beings. So there were some concerns and conflicts, I think, during that time. We already talked about ki all these additional equipment needed to comply with Bharat Stage VI requires money. So we are very happy that from April 2020, we'll be getting. So some of the investment has already taken place. Thousands of crores have been invested in oil companies and thousands of crores have been invested by the engine manufacturing companies or auto companies. And similarly, thousands of crores will be taken from the consumer also in the form of higher initial cost of that vehicle or automobile. So every technology which is available is at a price. And nobody else is responsible. I would always say that we ourselves are responsible. So we have made ourselves so dependent on these that I think today the number of vehicles are growing also exponentially. So again, I'll give you one personal experience which I have faced. I joined NIT Jalandhar in 1997, and it is almost 23 years. In 1997, there used to be 4 or 5 vehicles in our campus, which is spread across 154 acres. One vehicle was ambassador with our principal. Another was an ambassador with one of the faculty members. Incidentally, I also had one vehicle, Maruti, one bus, institute bus, that's all. And today, if I see, there are more than 100 houses which has got more than 2 vehicles. One family having more vehicle than we used to have the entire campus. 4-4 bhi hai logon ke paas. To pollution kahan se kam ho jayegi? So this is exponential growth of number of vehicles which are directly proportional to the emission pollutants. And before I is it time available or we should conclude now?
Yes.
Hani?
We have
10-12 minutes. So now I'll come to the concluding remarks. And I want your participation into this. Do you seriously feel that by upgradation, we'll be able to combat or able to reduce the environment of pollution which we are talking? Okay, we are happy that we are switching over to Bharat Stage VI. So, kya aapko April 2020 in the month of May, June, July or the next winters Delhi mein aayengi ya kahin bhi aayengi jo log bahut kya aapko fresh air milni shuru ho jayegi? So itna fir taam jam karne ka fayda kya hoga?
Haan ji?
Okay. Actually, we are all students of science. The rate of growth of pollutants are not reducing. Aap rate of growth nahi samajh rahe. The rate at which we are producing and rate at which we are combating, they are mismatch. And because of it, the resultant would be an addition. There would not be any submission of these pollutants. Now, the only message I would like to give, and you should also give, is not to use the vehicles and come to the our previous bicycles. These technologies are there for the businessmen, and in a way indirectly we are paying the huge taxes which we collect, give to the government, to the developed nations in acquiring these technologies. These technologies have now come free to us. We have acquired these technologies. Our government has paid for this. But if we limit our aspiration, our ambitions to that extent, then I think. And second thing is to have a dedicated transport network for all the cities. Individually, if we depend upon, it cannot resolve. Collectively, at the government level, at a huge setup, then only it can be reduced.